Hey, so I'm David Yao. I'm at UCLA in Dr. Kosuri's lab, and I'm working on a couple really cool projects. I'm basically trying to genetically engineer mammalian cell lines with what we call landing pads. These landing pads are basically regions within the genome that we can easily introduce different genetic packages. So in the field of synthetic biology, which is kind of like programming, except instead of binary zeros and ones, we work with DNA. We're trying to introduce a lot of different things into mammalian cell lines to either give them new functions or to study existing functions within various genes that exist. So, born and raised in sunny Southern California, West Coast, best coast. So my parents have backgrounds in engineering and programming, but in terms of their actual day-to-day jobs, they don't really do much science. Growing up, I was not exposed to science at all. In our house, we spoke more about business, history, politics, instead of science, but I don't think it really makes that big of a difference. And if anything, being exposed to the social sciences, to history, politics, current events, I think that's also very important for people who want to make a career out of science, because the work that we do is inherently tied to society's demands, society's needs. So I think it's really important. In synthetic biology, we really try to understand all that has been done throughout life, throughout evolution. Obviously, in these hundreds of millions, billions of years, there have been many cells, and these cells have learned to evolve tools to solve complex problems. You know, how to regulate cell division, how to store energy, how to generate energy. As synthetic biologists, we try to take all the things we've learned about how these cells do things, and we try to hack it or engineer it to fulfill our own purposes. So, for example, we see bacteria that can break down toxins, break down sludge, and turn it into energy. What if we could do the same thing with wastewater, you know, water that's been polluted? What if we can not only filter water, but at the same time generate electricity from it? That would be huge. Also things like hacking bacteria to turn sugar into fuel, you know. There's so much potential in synthetic biology, and we have all of research to draw from as inspiration and motivation to solve some of these complicated problems. So my project in the lab is working on developing these landing pads, genetically engineering cells in such a way that it'll be easy for us to introduce new genetic material into them afterwards. So we can study a wide range of genes, diseases, cell states. In terms of the types of techniques and tools that I work with, a lot of cell culturing theme requires us to work in cell culture hoods just to keep things very sterile. There's a lot of pipetting work that goes into it, but a lot of precision as well. Especially when it comes to dealing with mammalian cells, some of them are very finicky to culture. Some of these cell lines are cancer cell lines. We have brain cancer cell lines, different kidney tumor cell lines. And so by putting these landing pads in these different cell lines, we can then study them in parallel, and we can see how these tumors are similar, how they're different, and how they respond to similar genetic manipulations. So this way we can get an understanding of, you know, what genes are dysregulated in these different cell types, what might we do to fix them to get them to start working normally. And in general, we just want to tinker with different pieces of these genes to really get a good idea of what's going on inside. So there are a lot of factors that really motivated me to get into and continue my tenure in science. And I think a lot of it has to do with the fact that diseases that society is really faced and challenged with today aren't the types of diseases that people faced, you know, 50, 100 years ago. It's no longer these illnesses that strike really quickly, but rather it's chronic diseases, you know, Alzheimer's, brain disease, cancer. A lot of these diseases have genetic bases. And so in order to tackle them, it's really important that we understand things on the genetic level and even be able to genetically engineer solutions to them. But also, and so that's one reason why I really felt like, for me, going into genetics was a good way to go. But what really motivates me to continue in the field is the fact that it's just so exciting. You know, there's a silent revolution going on, and people in the public don't really hear about the behind the scenes of science, about this exciting race that's just constantly going forward with scientists around the world just trying to discover the next step, trying to see what's going on. And being in the field, you're pretty much at the forefront of that. You get the bird's eye view, you see what's going on. And it's just exciting because you realize that all the things you've seen in the movies, it's not just science fiction anymore. It's a practical day-to-day reality. People are making these things possible. And the questions that we didn't even know how to ask are now being answered. And so seeing those things and also thinking ahead, you know, what's society going to look like 10 to 20 years in the future? Technology is really what drives societies to change. And once we enable some of these genetic engineering tools, synthetic biology, once they become a lot more empowered, it's just, I don't know, it's just exhilarating to even begin thinking about what the world's going to become, you know, 20 years from now. And so I think that chasing after this excitement, this, you know, this grand drama, I think being in the field is definitely the best front row seat that you can get.
Thank you.